Good morning, students. In the previous class, we discussed about the disadvantaged group, which was physically and mentally handicapped. In this, we discussed the definition of disabled. Then we discussed the PWD Act, that is the Act for Disabled, and what are the various provisions which government has provided them so that they could be provided equal opportunities and equal access to various kind of services. Now in this video today, we'll discuss about deprivation of rights of disabled, right? As these are the disadvantaged group, and disadvantaged groups are the people who generally have lower status or are given less opportunities or are in such a situation that their rights could be hurt very easily. So disabled are also one such a group. So how these rights are deprived, we are going to discuss these points in this video today. The first way in which deprivation of rights occurs is in terms of access. Because of these points, the access is denied to the disabled. First is architectural barriers. Architectural barriers means whatever resistance or the problems produced due to the architecture of a building or a place, these people, the disabled, are not able to access those buildings or those places. It includes lack of ramps. If ramps will not be there, no wheelchair can move, or the absence of railings or proper signage, braille prints. Braille prints are required for the blinds. Adequate spacing. If it is not there, then also wheelchair cannot move. Slip resistant floors should be there. Accessible toilets and chairs. Switches should be at a accessible height. People who move on wheelchair should have switches at a lower height. Shelves, wash basins, taps and telephones, all at an accessible height. So if these kind of facilities are not provided in public places, then that leads to architectural barrier, and that obviously creates a problem of access. Second reason which creates problem of access is inaccessibility to quality education. Right, everybody is supposed to have equal opportunity for good quality of education, but the disabled are not able to access good quality education. Right, in the areas like education, special schools are there, no doubt. Teaching aids are given to such students. Books are provided in braille system, and interpreters are there for hearing and speech impaired people. But still, all these things are not in sufficient quantity. It means the number of disabled is much, much more than the facilities provided by the government. So many of them are still lacking the access to good quality education. Then the third point is inaccessibility to entertainment. Various entertainment sources which are present at public places are generally not built keeping in view the accessibility for the disabled. Generally, disabled are not able to access the entertainment sources such as theaters, libraries, public libraries, as these are not designed keeping in view the accessibility to the disabled persons. Then inaccessibility to technology. All technology is not available to all types of people. People who are not able to see, means who are blind, cannot access or use the technology. For people with disability, the majority of internet related technologies are inaccessible. Still, we don't have such a technology which can be used by people who are lacking in certain abilities. For example, people who experience visual impairment may face problem due to a lack of compatibility of web content with the screen reader they use. So this is how disabled are deprived of their right to accessibility to various public places or various facilities. The second is employment. Disability Act 1995 provide for 3% reservation in all categories in the jobs in government sector. We have already discussed in the previous video about this thing. But still, most of the disabled are not able to get a job. So if they are not able to get a job, obviously their livelihood will be a problem, and further their rights would be violated. Then the next deprivation is in terms of education. In India, education to the disabled is not provided as a part of main schools. Special schools are built for them, and obviously the quality of education which a special school has is not at par to the main schools. But through other isolated special schools which operate on a service and charity mode, generally we find that in our country special schools are run by NGOs or some other charity organizations. So in those organizations or in those special schools, much of focus is not given on the higher quality of the education. There are only around 3000 special schools in India today. Out of these, 900 schools are for the hearing impaired, 400 for children with visual impairment, means who cannot see, 700 for locomotor disability, means who cannot move, and 1000 for the mentally disabled who are having any kind of mental disorder. So we can very well see that it is very small number in comparison to the normal schools, and the number of disabled is much higher. So there is a mismatch of demand and supply equation. So there is a high need to have much more schools for disabled. Another government sponsored program is IEDC, that is Integrated Education for Disabled Children. Integrated means this education has been integrated with the normal schools, main schools, in which around 50,000 children with disability are enrolled. Like people having locomotor disability are mentally fit to study in the main schools. So for them, IEDC program has been run. And under this, various disabled can enroll themselves into the main schools. This has reduced the problem of demand supply, which we discussed in previous point. But still, the number of children who have been enrolled under this program is very small, which is 50,000 only till date. But integrated schools don't have special provision of resource rooms, special aides and special teachers. Here also, under this program IEDC, we have seen various problems that the main schools, the schools where this integrated programs are run, they do not have special provisions regarding the resource rooms which these disabled require, or they do not have any special aid which could be provided to these students, and they also lack special teachers. These education options are restricted only to big cities. Another problem, there are no special schools or schools for disabled in the small towns or in backward areas. Only big cities have this facility. So we can very well imagine that the students or the children who are disabled and who reside in the backward areas or in rural areas or semi-urban areas, they are not able to get any opportunity for education. There are no special schools or education services in the rural parts. And facilities of pre-vocational and vocational training programs are provided by very limited specialized institutions. Vocational training programs, we know, are job-oriented training programs, and these kind of training programs are very much necessary to create employment opportunities. But we see that in India, we have very few vocational training programs who are meant for these disabled. So obviously the people who are disabled are not able to get any vocational training programs, and that's why the employment opportunities are also very less for them. Then next deprivation of rights is in terms of discrimination, that these people are highly discriminated from the normal ones. The uniform society cannot see people with differences without discrimination. There is a lot of disgrace attached to disability. People look toward a person with disability through disgrace. The other discrimination faced by them is in terms of access to places. Obviously, these people are not able to access each and every place where a normal person can go, which we have already discussed in the point of accessibility. Public buildings, public transport systems, and other places of importance are not accessible to them. Either they are not able to move because of lack of ramps, if they are using wheelchairs, or if they are blind or hearing impaired, in that situation also they require special aids or facilities to move to these public places which are not provided by the government. Then lastly, the employment opportunities available to them are also very low, as I have discussed in the previous slide also, that the vocational training programs are very few, so they have less education about various kinds of vocations, and also these are not fit for all kind of employment opportunities. So in that terms also, because of their disability, they are having a limitation in terms of employment. So they suffer because of unemployment, and further their rights are violated. They suffer the triple jeopardy, which is disability, poverty and disgrace. So all together, all these factors together create a lot of humiliation to the disabled. Then this attitudinal problem, various kinds of attitudinal problems are also faced by these people. The attitude of the society towards disabled is insensitive. They don't think their viewpoint, or they don't think how they will feel. They relate disabled with their disability rather than with their abilities. They see what they cannot do, but they cannot see what they are able to do. So in terms of ability, they are not judged. In terms of disability, they are judged. Such behavior violate the right of disabled to live with dignity. So they face lots of such situations in which their dignity is being harmed. So their right to live with dignity is affected. And lastly, the lack of proper rehabilitation care. Rehabilitation of disabled can be done in various ways, like vocational rehabilitation, so that they can be prepared for doing certain jobs. Vocational training should be provided to them, or educational services should be provided to them. If they are not able to move to educational centers, in that situation, home support should be given to them. Child services should be given to them so that they can help, the special teachers can help them in growing and properly learning the content which is required for their age. And residential living arrangements also, certain institutions could be opened where residential arrangement is also there, means hostels are also there, and the special children's or the children with disability are admitted over there, and education and other training programs are conducted for them for their betterment. Such rehabilitation care programs are not easily available to the disabled people in our country. Such programs are very limited, and according to the number of disabled, those numbers are not sufficient to handle that particular big number of disabled in our country, right? So with this, this topic is over, and this chapter is over. In next video, we'll discuss another disadvantaged group.